वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला. दिस इज डॉक्टर मृन्मय प्रामाणिक. आई टीच कंपेरेटिव इंडियन लैंग्वेज एंड लिटरेचर एट द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कैलकटा. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ मॉड्यूल ऑन द प्रोज बाय द यूरोपियन डिसेंडेंट राइटर्स ऑफ यूरोपियन ओरिजिन पैट्रिक व्हाइट एंड हिज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन in prose style, Australian prose writing. When we see the emergence of new literature from Australia, Canada and New Zealand, we find different kind of remarkable literary contribution. One type of literary contribution is the contribution by the colonizers or the Europeans, who actually mainly tried to record or archiving the document, language and some literary elements of the indigenous communities. And we see the literature written by the European descent, writers of European origin. And later we see the remarkable writings by the indigenous people of Australia, Canada and New Zealand. When we talk about new literature or literature of South Pacific of such kind of regions, we have to talk about the literature written by the European descent also, because the writing of European descent and the writing of the indigenous people both created a new dialogue to understand the European, to understand the indigenous people and the relation between indigenous and the European people and the history of post-colony and the history of this post-relation. And through this dialogue between the indigenous people and writers of European descent, the new identity of the community, new literary sphere of the language and the country has been made. And these two dialogues actually talks about the identity and memory. The literature of these people in new literature actually talks about the memory, and this is the new to be offered to the world. I quote, "Perhaps more so than in other countries, the literature of Australia characteristically expresses collective values. Even when the literature deals with the experiences of an individual, those experiences are very likely to be estimated in terms of the ordinary, the typical, the representative. It aspires on the whole to represent integration rather than disintegration. It does not favor the heroism of individual action unless this shows dogged perseverance in the face of inevitable defeat, although it may express a strong, ironic disapproval of collective mindlessness. The object of criticism is the mindlessness rather than the conformity." Unquote. Now, the thing is that if we see the history of life writing or the modern contemporary life writing, then we can find that any privileged society, any society who holds power, or the society or the race or the people who rule over the other people, they allow people to write their autobiography if that person is larger than life. Then only in privileged society that person is allowed to write autobiography or memoir or diary or anything, any sort any kind of or any sort of genres that person can practice. And that person has to be larger than life or larger than the society. And that autobiography writing particularly create a demarcation between that person and the society. And it always shows that that person is not limited into that society or that people. And this is how that person get a hierarchical position that people from that society or that community has to stand up to look that person or the life story of that person. And it is always considered or assumed that life should be celebrating or life should be worth noting. Then only the person can write about the life story and life writing. But the story is completely different for the oppressed class or oppressed community or the people who are marginal or the people who believe in collective life, like the indigenous people, the primitive society people, people like primitive society people and the aboriginal people, because their oppression, their voice is to establish themselves against the oppression, because voice is tried to be oppressed by some other agency and they want to establish themselves against that. And that is why they are talking. They are talking about themselves. And as they practice a collective life and a community life, whenever any person is talking about herself or himself, that person automatically is talking about the community. And for any oppressed class, it is kind of similar. As for example, we can take example of the Indian Dalit writing. And when a Dalit literary figure is writing about her or his autobiography, it is very common to the other people of that community or the similar community. It is very common. So that is why they don't want to, and that narrative does not show that the person whose life writing has been written is actually that person does not have any connection with the society, or that person is larger than life. It is not assumed, or it is not represented, or it is not shown. We can take one more example of a testimony by Rigoberta Menchú and that book called I, Rigoberta Menchú. When Rigoberta Menchú wrote about herself, it appeared as a collective writing, not only a writing about some particular person. And if you if we read the literature by Sally Morgan or Kerry Hulme, the Bond People, or Sally Morgan's My Place, we can see that this is not about the individual but about the collective life, but about the collective people. In Australia, we can see that the literary practices, like any other colony, happened since the 18th century with the invasion of the Europeans and with the documentation of different language, linguistic documentation, and the documentation of different cultural elements, cultural products and literary products, oral tradition, etc. And later on, in the end of 19th century and throughout the 20th century, we can see the emergence of group of new writers in the field of Australian Aboriginal writing or Australian literature. But what we mentioned earlier, that the European descent or the writing by the European origin, writers of European origin, is also very important to understand the Aboriginal life, to understand the post the life after the colony, and to understand the colonial rule also. And one of that famous writing is about the one of such kind of famous writer is Patrick White and his literary contribution. Australian literature in the English language covers the period 1788 to the present day and includes not only fiction, verse, drama, history, biography, and autobiography, but also journals, diaries, letters, and memoirs. The literature of the first 100 years of European settlement in Australia reflects the feelings and observations of people who often had not been born in Australia and who in many cases had no wish to be in the country. Early Australian literature reflects this unusual social context and physical demands of the environment. The 20th century has seen the emergence of writers whose literary merits has been recognized beyond Australia. The themes of their writing tend to be more urban-oriented, internationalist, and cosmopolitan than the penal and rural topics of 19th century authors. So, through the writing of 19th century and 20th century, we can find the differences between the themes. That 19th century talks more about the rural life or the life of people, which is very much related with the nature, and 20th century observe the different kind of life, different kind of worldview through the literature, that it talks about the urban life, the urbanization, new industry, industrialization, and people, you know, are talking through literary practices, people were becoming more international. They were connecting through the international, through the literature, they were connecting with the international affairs. And this 19th century and 20th century literature, it is very interesting to observe that literature of European origin or European descendant is not only about the carrying European impression or European cultures or tradition, but that literature or the people of such kind of writers, they belong neither to Europe nor to Australian Aboriginal life completely, but they carry both the impression of European tradition and heritage and culture, belief, worldview, and they also carry the Aboriginal Australian tradition, culture, heritage, and worldview. And because of that, their writing is very interesting, and it offers a different kind of identity question, and we can observe a different kind of identity formation. Another kind of identity formation we can observe with the indigenous writing and indigenous Aboriginal writing, and a different kind of identity formation we can observe through the writing of the European descendant. Patrick White was born in 1912 and he was died in 1990. He is very famous Australian author, and he has a worldwide critical reception he has. He published 12 novels and 30 short stories, and he also a playwright, and he wrote many screenplays. In 2011, his novel The Eye of the Storm was adapted for movie. White was born in Knightsbridge, London, to Victor Martindale White and Ruth Nee Widdicombe. Both Australians in their apartment overlooking Hyde Park, London, on 28th May 1912, and his family returned to Sydney, Australia. And in 1932 to 1935, White lived in England. He was studying French, German literature in King's College, Cambridge University, and later he came back to Australia, and he adopted both the heritage, culture, and the thoughts and the worldviews from this different worlds of thought, from these different cultures. His fierce denunciation of modern Western society, particularly Australian post-war middle class, eventually earned him an undeserved title of Australia's most unreadable novelist. It may rightly be argued that Australia in the 1950s and 1960s was yet not prepared for the writers like White. Generally, the readers still expected literature to be lifelike and easy, and they were not interested in works of the imagination that unsettle the surface of things. And that is why the Patrick was quite different than any other writer. And he actually wished to uncover the mystery and the poetry. And he wished to populate his ideas as the great Australian emptiness. And because of that, he is very much debated writer. Because the kind of writing, the kind of narrative and the theme Patrick White was offering through his literary practices was very uncommon to his time and to the readers for whom he was writing. And it was very much uncommon and unique for that Australian literary culture also. That is why Patrick was highly debated, and there was a different type of reception or reaction of the readers, of his readers. He wrote for the first time in 1939, and it was a breakthrough when his novel Happy Valley was published in London and later in America by the Viking Press. And during the Second World War, White served as an intelligence officer for the RAF in Egypt, Palestine and Greece. And as a result, he collected a different kind of experience, and he has memories of different world, different kind of civilization in this world, and those are reflected in one or different way in his literature. His notable works are like The Tree of Man in 1955, Bhos 1957, and Riders in the Chariot 1961. These three novels, The Tree of Man, Bhos, and Riders in the Chariot, were actually well received throughout the world, and several translations, especially the several European translation of these texts, are found. Australians finally accorded him recognition and respect by selecting Bhos as the winner of the inaugural Miles Franklin Literary Award. White won the award again in 1961 for Riders in the Chariot, and again in 1968 for the Vivisector. After winning the Britain Award in 1968, the relatively wealthy author decided that he would not accept any more prizes for his work. White's stature as a leading international writer was enshrined in 1973 when he became the first Australian to receive the Nobel Prize for Literature. The Swedish Academy cited his epic and psychological narrative art, which has introduced a new continent into literature. So with this, the recognition by the Swedish Academy by the award of Nobel Prize, Patrick White became more famous and more celebrating author all over the world, because Patrick White was recognized or identified as a contributor of through the creation of epic about the continent. Because what he was telling, it was not particularly about any community or race. He was writing the saga of the continent, which is Australia, and the first Australian to receive the Nobel Prize in literature. And that is his most brilliant significance, and most significance and brilliancy, that he was able to successfully portray the saga, the life, and the conflict, psychological conflict of the communities who were staying in Australia. So he appeared as the writer of, author of Epic, the Epic, what talks about Australia. And this is how Patrick White is received through the literary practitioners all over the world. At the earlier period of his writing career, Patrick White experienced considerable problems with his national identity, which in the manner of late 20th century post-colonial theorists like Ashcroft, Griffith and Tiffin, among others, believed was a dynamic, changeable phenomena. The personal experiences doubtless reflected in a variety of his writings threw off sparks for the then contemporary Australia, forecasting what was to become one of the hottest issues in today's debates and discourses of post-colonial studies, that is, the problem of self-identity, national identity, or hybrid identity, unquote. And through the reading of Patrick White, we can understand it easily that it is not only the problem of Patrick White, the personal problem of Patrick White, what he has to face throughout his life for getting different kind of experiences in different continents of this world, or being trained in different kind of cultural society, and being trained with different cultures. It is not only his personal problem, but he felt it, he observed this problem as one of the crucial problem for the contemporary man, for the contemporary people, as the post-colonial theorists argue that this is the conflict of identities and the problem of hybrid identity, national identity and the self-identity. And that problem is also very crucial in the context of imagining Australian national literature. Because the Australian national literature, as we mentioned earlier, that it is made by the literature of the Aboriginal people, the indigenous people, and it talks about their identity, which is very different than the identity of the other people, like the people of the European descent. That European descent people, they are not carrying completely the European identity, and they are not carrying also completely the Aboriginal or indigenous or Australian identity. But this mixed identity, or this conflict between or among the identities, create another identity problem. And these identity problems problematize the question of nationalism, the question of national literature in the context of Australian literature. So this was addressed. Such kind of psychological problems or psychological issues were addressed by Patrick White in his different novels. And this problem also is a matter or subject of importance or significance to the post-colonial theorist. And because of that, Patrick White is also an author of great interest to the post-colonial theorist of the West. An instance of this, what we are talking now, the instance of this could be the privileging of nature over civilization, or and civilization over nature. The issue current in Australian or white literature since its early beginning in the late 18th century, when we say that nature preceded civilization, we are asserting a violent hierarchy in which a prior presence lords itself over a mere supplement. However, if we look closely enough, we find that nature is always already contaminated with the civilization. There is no original nature, only a myth which we desire to promote and which White wanted to undo most evidently in The Tree of Man, 1955, attempting as it were to equate civilization with nature and on nature with civilization, unquote. Such kind of questions appeared very crucial to Patrick White, because Patrick White was truly identified by the Scottish Academy that he is the author of Epic of a Continent. When in the tree man, he was a tree of man, he was talking about the relation between the nature, myth, and the human being, he was actually talking about the Australian political context, which was disturbed, and the Australian natural environmental context, which was disturbed with the invasion of the Europeans, because the Europeans, they make a detachment between the land, people, and nature. And this problem has been crucially problematized in his novel, The Tree of Man. And that is why The Tree of Man also carries a history of psyche of a continent, history of psyche of a continent, which has been existing there in last few centuries, I mean more than two centuries, and that is vividly, truly represented, portrayed in Patrick's this novel. Australian literature can be understood as literature of the settler colony, representing a complexity of the formation of both Australian cultural identity and its culture of the original Aboriginal inhabitants was based on oral tradition, which was either suppressed or could not compete with Australian literature based on a written tradition. During the colonization of Australia, when the country was established as a British penal colony in 1788, Australian literature was influenced by British literary tradition. And we can observe through the writing of the Europeans who were settled in Australia and the writing of European descent, that initial writing of these two categories of authors actually was reflecting the European influence, and they were carrying the baggage of European legacy through their literature. We had to wait until the new generation of European descent emerged as a writer in Australia and the indigenous writer appeared in the scene in 20th century and the second half of the 20th century. Then we get the new kind of literature. And Patrick White is one among those authors who has this historical significance in literature, who actually brought a new wave in Australian literature, which was not carrying the baggage of legacy of European literary heritage or European literary understanding. White's forte as a novelist is amplitude, not so much in presenting the eternal struggle between the self and the universe, as in portraying the futilities and the tragedies of life, and in revealing the continuity and the process of the cycle of existence, which begins and ends and begins again, unquote. And this is the most significant contribution of Patrick White in the Australian literary history. White also, I quote, White has attempted to highlight the drama of conflicting human situation through a spiritual viewpoint against the banal surface of Australian society, and argued it out as the dominant theme of his works, unquote. And this is not only the unique, this concept was not only unique to the play, but it was this thought, this concept of that spirituality, this concept of conflict of human being and human situation through a spirituality, also was portrayed through his different novels, like Vos, like The Tree of Man, different kind of novels, and the and different kind of novels and short stories carries this thought, and that is why this thought was not unique to his play only. Now, let us summarize our discussion. Through this discussion, we tried to talk about the importance of life writing, because somehow this writing of Aboriginal Indigenous literature, Australian literature, Canadian literature, New Zealand literature by the European descendant carries the essence of life writing in to some extent. So we talked about the life writing. We talked about the Australian prose, the modernity and Australian literature, the colonialism and Australian literature, the growth and development of Australian literature by the different forces, by the different agencies, and the Australian literature as new literature, and the Australian Aboriginal literature and the literature by the Australian European descent. And we tried to situate Patrick White in that context, in that literary, political, historical context. And we tried to problematize the concept of writing, the concept of what we get through Patrick's writings. We tried to understand it through different references, and we tried to understand the problems, what Patrick has represented being an author of epic of our continent. For further reading, you can consult the reference and further reading list. And for self-assessment, you can find the self-assessment file here along with the e-text. Thank you.